The Green Republic Project is a youth-driven, not-for-profit grassroots climate action fight, focusing on tree planting as a natural remedy to the climate fight. The overarching goal is to plant 20 million trees by 2028. This ambition began on 1st July 2018 in the northern region with a total of 10,950 trees planted till date. The Green Republic is calling for a National Tree Planting Day as an emergency and creative approach to dealing with the climate change. And joining us in the studio this morning to discuss this is the convener of Green Republic in the person of Nanayao Osei Dakoa. Good morning, Nanayao.
Good morning, Christine. Thanks for having me.
Awesome. I like how you're representing Ghana this morning.
Yeah, I mean, Ghana for life.
Ghana for life. Green Republic, indeed. Yeah. I want to start by congratulating you, actually, because 10,950 trees, that's a lot.
Thank you, Amy, but it's a lot, but it's a drop in the ocean, you know, because as you rightly said, we're looking at planting 20 million trees or even more in the next 10 years. And so for us, it's the beginning. I mean, it's just a year, and we still appreciate what we've done, but we can do better.
You can do better, certainly.
And that's even why, you know, like you said, you know, we're calling for a national tree planting day.
Yes.
You know, we think that we need to do this for ourselves as a people, because yesterday, you know, I heard His Excellency the President talk at the Climate Change Conference and talked about the fact that globally it's been agreed that the world has 12 years to deal with this climate challenge. Mm-hmm. And if we have 12 years, then it's just a little over a decade, and we need to double our efforts.
Indeed.
And rightly, as the President said, we need to be aggressive. But we are saying that we need to be very deliberate, you know, about the fight.
Yeah.
And so that is why we're calling for a National Tree Planting Day.
Tree Planting Day.
A day where all Ghanaians will step out.
Yeah.
I mean, it should not be a holiday. It should be, let's say, the first Saturday of every July, which is the rainy season, where we all go out, from His Excellency the President to the ordinary Ghanaian.
Yes.
Now, if you look at the landscape now, you have a lot of tree planting projects going on.
Yeah.
I mean, we say we want to do 20 million. I know of a project that the great king of Ashanti, Otunfor Osei Tutu II, is also embarking on. The king of Achimbi Ibuakwa, you know, state, Osagyefo Omotio for Ipenin, also doing something. Even the state itself, through the youth in afforestation, also doing stuff. And so what we are saying is that we need to pull these things together and then as a nation rally and do a massive project, you know, so that if we say we have a National Tree Planting Day where all Ghanaians are coming together, His Excellency leading the charge as the Commander-in-Chief of the Ghana Armed Forces, bringing out the military, the police, the fire service, the customs exercise, we're talking about students. I mean, everybody coming together. We are going to, you know, post a certain card to the rest of the world that we are serious about this thing, because globally it's been accepted that trees are going to play a major role in the fight against climate change.
That's
and
true.
So that's why we call in for this. We need to do this for our country.
Mm.
And we're going to insist and call on our leaders to do this for Ghana and for generations unborn.
Okay, that's a good one. But I'm looking at the organization of this. You're saying that it doesn't have to be a holiday.
Yeah.
It can be, say, a weekend, a Saturday. First Saturday in July, perhaps. I think you are proposing that date.
Yeah, we're proposing that date because July, you know, falls within the rainy season of Ghana. We're looking at a viewpoint where we wouldn't have to get people going to water the trees that we plant, because during the rainy season, at least every 2-3 other days, we're going to have some rain. You know?
Exactly.
So that's why we propose in July, you know, within the rainy
season. So how do you plan for this to actually happen? Is it you said to come together? So I'm thinking you are saying just to unite to do this. Where are we going to plant the trees?
Yeah.
Your organization started from the northern region of Ghana.
Yes.
But how do the people also come in this? Do they just go to their backyard? Some people don't have soil in their backyards. They have maybe tiles and, you know, paper blocks. So how do they go about this?
Yes. So what we're going to do, or what we are proposing, is this: that for instance, the Ministry for Lands and Natural Resources and its allied agency, the Forestry Commission.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, once we come to an agreement as a nation that we're going to have this, I think it falls under their purview to be able to pull us all together to do this.
Okay.
So then the state can budget to say, okay, we're planting in July. So from now, we're going to nest, let's say, 30 million saplings to grow in July.
Okay.
And then it spreads across the districts, regions, districts, constituencies, so that MPs, you know, district chief executives, you know, everybody would have a certain quota of trees to plant. And then we all go out. People can plant, let's say, fruit trees in their homes.
Okay.
You know, and then we can look at our forest, our depleted forest.
Depleted forest.
This particular thing gives us an opportunity to even restock our depleted, you know, traditional species like the sapulis and the wawas and odums. And, you know, we can say that, okay, during year one, tree planting, national tree planting day, we're going to do, let's say, 40% of traditional species and, you know, other species, or 60% of, so that through this creative approach, we'll be able to restock even our traditional species and also make this country green. We're saying that we have to be very, very deliberate about what whatever we want to achieve.
Indeed.
We cannot achieve anything by, you know, doing things, you know, in anyhow and anyway. We need to be very focused and deliberate if we really mean business. Globally, everybody has come to that conclusion that trees will play a major role in the fight against climate change. And so what prevents us from doing this for our country
for generations as well? Exactly.
Especially when we have only 12 years to fight the climate challenge.
The climate challenge. That's true. It, some trees take much less time to mature as well. So
it would amaze you. We planted 3,500 trees in a village called Yong Dakpemili in the northern region.
Northern,
and I was there July this year, where we did, you know, extra planting, and the height of the, they're taller than myself.
Wow.
And I'm amazed. Just a year.
Yeah.
You know, so it even encouraged, you know, us more that definitely if we grow these things, we're going to see a beautiful country where people are even going to walk. For instance, if you have trees from this stretch, let's say Tete Kwashi all the way to National Theater area, and you are coming to TV3, bet you me, people will walk without even feeling they are walking.
Indeed.
And that will be good for our health because of the shade.
Yes, and the fresh air as well.
Exactly. And we don't tend to walk because now it's too warm out there.
Yeah.
You walk a bit and you sweat all over. So these things have its own health implications. It means that we're going to take a lot of carbons out of the atmosphere, so our people do not get to be breathing these carbons into themselves, you know, for all manner of health-related diseases. So it's a gamut of benefits that we're going to gain as a people, if we are able to do this.
So doing planting, you planted so far
10,950.
Exactly. Yeah. What were the main challenges with that? Because again, with change comes challenge, and you are trying to change habits of people.
Yeah.
So what were the main challenges?
It's a big challenge. I mean, people do not really appreciate, I mean, why you're going out there to plant trees in the first place. And you know, a young man, you know, you have a lot of things to do while you're planting trees.
Yes.
And most of our young people have never planted a tree in their lives.
Mm.
And yet, we are taught in school that the oxygen that we breathe comes from the trees.
Yes,
so I think that we should all, you know, make it a point that at least at a certain point in our lives, we are going to go out there and plant a tree.
Yeah.
Now, the challenge is this. One, funding.
Yeah.
You know,
okay.
It's so difficult.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, I mean, when you have passion for something, you know, funds cannot be an obstacle.
Okay.
Now, when we realized that we're challenged, you know, during the launch of the project, we contacted the Forestry Commission of Ghana.
Yeah.
And under the able leadership of Sir John, they decided to support our cause by, you know, helping us with seedlings.
Seedlings.
Now, this is their core mandate.
Okay.
And so he thought that if we are going to help do these things,
exactly,
then they need to also support us.
You.
And not just that, they were also going to give us technical support.
Okay.
Because we are not technical people.
Okay.
We are just young Ghanaians who are passionate about seeing our country overcome climate change.
Awesome.
And so they also support us with the technical stuff.
Okay.
And so that challenge of getting funds to, but again, we need to travel. We did this in northern Ghana.
Yes, certainly.
The hotel, you know, bills,
so
that
essentially,
be paid and all that.
Yeah.
Difficult, but difficulties are meant to be overcome.
Yes.
And so for us, I mean, those cannot be obstacles stopping us.
Stopping us.
We will find creative means to go around these things and get it delivered.
Okay, all right. That's a good one. Trees are certainly life for all of us. They should be our best friends. I'd like for you to advise all your stakeholders right now. We have only a few seconds to go. So quick advice to the people out there, to the Forestry Commission, EPA, Ministry of Agri,
them. I'm calling, you know, humbly on His Excellency, the President, Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, who also happens to be a co-chair of the UN Eminent Committee for SDGs, and then to the Minister of Lands and Natural Resources, Forestry Commission, the EPA, Ministry of Science and Technology, and indeed the entirety of the Ghanaian populace, that we need to have this National Tree Planting Day to accelerate the pace of our fight against climate change.
Great.
I mean, there's no doubt about that. Yeah. We have to do this for God and country.
For God
and for generations unborn.
And generations unborn. Well, you've heard it from Nana Yao Osei Dakwa, the convener of Green Republic. We are pushing for a National Tree Planting Day, and I hope that it's actually passed. So there's a saying, the last tree dies, the last man dies.
Absolutely.
We should save ourselves and save the planet as well.